Question number 23. A. On the grid provided, draw the square whose vertices are A 6 minus 2, B 7 minus 2, C 7 minus 1, and D 6 minus 1. So we have B. So we have our grid here. Should be able to label your axis and plot the square given the vertices. So B, on the same grid, draw ABCD prime, the image of ABCD under enlargement scale factor 3, our center of rotation is 9 minus 4. We have Roman number 2, ABCD double prime, the image of ABCD prime under a reflection in the line x is equals to 0. Roman number 3, ABCD triple prime, the image of ABCD double prime under a reflection of 90 degrees, positive 90 degrees about 0, 0. And C, describe a single transformation that maps ABCD prime onto ABCD triple prime. Now, here you are being tested. For example, B, we are being tested whether you know how to do the enlargement. And given the scale factor, what we normally do is we draw a line from the center of rotation to where we have our object. We extend it. The length from the center of the enlargement to the object you multiply by the scale factor to get the position of the image. So that's how you do the enlargement. This one, Roman number 2, it's about reflection. What do we follow, or what are the properties that we use to do a reflection? 1, the line joining the object and the image is perpendicular to the mirror line, and the distance from the object to the mirror line is equals to the distance from the mirror line to the image. So that is very important. Roman number 3 is about rotation. Rotation, the positive 90, it means it is a anti-clockwise direction. That the how we describe rotation. That is a positive rotation. Negative rotation is clockwise direction. So very important. And then another thing we need to note here is that the coordinates of when you are rotating through angle 90, we can be able to get the image by interchanging the coordinates of whatever we are rotating. We are going to see that. Then C, you compare the two rotations, the two images or objects, and see whether you can come up with a single transformation. So because of space, I'm going to use another board that is going to give us a bigger Cartesian plane to be able to do that. But those are the properties that we are going to follow. So we are going to start with enlargement, linear scale factor 3, and we have our center of rotation is 9 minus 4. I'm going to use this, enlarge the grid so that it can be visible. So we have our axis. So here we have, you can say this is 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we can say that is our x-axis. The other side we have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. We have 1, we have 2, we have 3, we have 4, we have 5, 6, 7. This is our y-axis. And we have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So our square, we are told it is at 6 minus 2, that is A is there. Our B is 7 minus 2, this is our B. Our C is 7 minus 1, so that's our C. And this is our D, 6 minus 1. So what we do is we join the 4 points. So this is what we get. That is what we get. That's not very good. So we get, let's try this, we draw that. So let me join the points and come up with a square. So this is the square that you come up with. Now we go to part B. Part B, like we saw, okay, let's go back to the question and see what is required. Part B, we are told on the same grid to draw ABCD plane, the image of ABCD under an enlargement scale factor 3 and center 9-4. So we are going to do that. We enlarge our diagram, scale factor 3 and center of rotation, center of enlargement 9-4. So let's do that. So we have seen that the center of rotation is, at its enlargement is 9-4, and scale factor is equals to 3. So what you do, okay, first of all, this is where we identify as a center of our enlargement. So you draw a line from the center of enlargement. We can say center of enlargement. You draw a line from there, passing each and every point. So you start from A, that is where we have our line there. You can take your compass or divider, and you measure 3 equal distance, that is from here to here, that is one, another one, and another one, and your A will run there. So that is where we have our A plane. Again, you draw a line from the center of the enlargement through B, and it will pass that somewhere there, and you measure equal distance. From here to here, you measure 2, 3, and your B plane, you land there. Then you do the same to C, so that that line will pass through there, and that will pass about to pass through there. You measure, that is 1, 2, 3. So that will be the position of C plane, and you repeat the same with the point D. Where is our point D? It will pass there. I think here we this is supposed to be a D, so our D plane will be there. So you join the 4 points, you come up with a square that has been enlarged. But Roman number 2, ABCD plane, the image of ABCD under refraction in the line x is equals to 0. So we reflect what we have enlarged, where the mirror line is x is equals to 0. So let's do that. So this is we have to say this is B, Roman number 1. We have Roman number 2, we are reflecting, so this is enlargement. This is a reflection. So the mirror line here is x is equals to 0. So x is equals to 0 is this point. So when you reflect A, it will be on the same position. So our A double prime will be the same position, because the mirror line x is equals to 0 is actually the y axis. When you reflect B, we can say it is 3 units on the positive, so B prime will be 1, 2, 3 on the opposite. So we have B double prime. D will remain the same position, so we have D because it lies on the mirror line. C will be 3 units on the negative side, so because the distance from the object to the mirror line is equal to the distance from the mirror line to the object. So our C double prime will be there, and from there we can now join the 4 points and come up with the triangle, or the square that has been enlarge. So we have we join that point, those points, we join another one here, and we join another one here, and that this one here. So they are sharing, AD is shared between the two triangles, and that is how you get now the second image. So we go back to the question and see what to do next. So Roman number 3, ABCD triple prime is the image of ABC double prime under a rotation of positive 90 degrees about 0, 0. So we are going to rotate our second image through positive 90 about 0, 0. So like I had mentioned, this is the positive rotation when we are rotating through the anti-clockwise, and this is a negative rotation when we are rotating clockwise. So we are rotating, so we have the third one is rotation, that is Roman number 3. We have the center of rotation is 0, 0. The angle of rotation is positive 90 degrees. So when we are rotating through an angle of 90, we can get the image by interchanging the x and y coordinates. For example, A is at 0, 2. So A will be, we'll get our A here. So this is our A, it will be minus 2, 0. B, we are rotating this, B is at 3, 2. So it will be, Y will be 3, and X will be 2. So it is, this is where we have our B triple prime. Our C is at minus 3, 5, so it will be minus 5, 3. So this is where we have our C triple prime. Our D is at 0, 5, so it will be 5, 0. So this is where we have our D triple prime. Then from there, we can join the 4 points and come up with the square that is required, that is here, that which where we have identified our point. So you use a ruler and you join the 4 points, you come up with our square. That is the third image. So that is the third image. So that is how you get that image. Let's see how the part C of the question. So part C, describe a single transformation that maps ABCD prime onto ABCD triple prime. So what you do in this part is you look at this image. This should be the first image. This is the third image, and see how you can relate them. How can you get this? How can you get the third image from directly from the first image? So let's do that. So we are supposed to relate ABCD prime. That is our first image. This is the first image, and this is our third image. This is our second image. How do you get this image from directly the third image from the first one? And if you look at this, it is kind of it's a refraction, looking at A and A, B and B, and the refraction is through the line. You can see from A to A, the midpoint, you can draw a line passing through that point, so that's a line connecting. So we can say the midpoint of this, you can get also the line joining A and B. So you can see the midpoint of that line is this, the midpoint of that line. So we can say this is you can get the third image, ABCD triple prime, from the first image through by reflecting this image through the line Y is equals to the line passing here. So this is the line passing here. Can draw that line. The middle. This is the line. we can say this is the line y is equals to minus x. You have dealt with this line for so many times, so you can say part C, you can answer, you can get that it drew a reflection through y is equals to minus x, and that is how you answer that question. I hope you have followed. A very easy question. As long as you follow the properties that we have learned in this is in transformation, you know how to enlarge. When you are enlarging, you are given the center of the enlargement, the linear scale factor or enlargement scale factor. So it is, for example, this is 3, so you know the distance from the from the center of rotation enlargement to the object is you multiply by the number, the enlargement factor, so this will be 3 times. So then you should be comfortable using your geometrical set. The second one is a reflection. We know the properties of a reflection. The line joining the object and the image is perpendicular to the mirror line. So if you join the, if you draw a line that is perpendicular to the mirror line, it will lead you to where the image is. Now, when you get that, the distance from the object to the image to the mirror line is equal to the distance from the mirror line to the image. So that way you can be able to locate the image. Then we have rotation. We have note that when we are rotating through and clockwise, that is referred to as positive rotation. This is negative rotation, that is clockwise. Then in Form 2, you are also taught how you can be able to get the rotated point if you are rotating through angle 9, positive 90, negative 90. I think 180, positive, negative 180, such. But however, if you are not able to do that, you can still get, since we are rotating this, you draw a line to the center of rotation, you measure the angle of that is a join a line from the object to the center of rotation, measure the angle of rotation, which is 90, you still get the position of A. Repeat with all the other points and you'll be able to get the image. So that is how we do such kind of question. It has taken long, but when you're using the geometrical set instrument, then that should be easy for you, because I'm changing from the question to where we are doing our diagrams. That is why it has taken a bit of time.